Hey, it's Mark Maxwell here, and I have a band on the red couch again. This is a band called Hush Harbor. Say hello, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
And Hush Harbor's a cool band from in town here. If you don't know about them, you should go to, what's the email address?
I mean, Hush Harbor Band.com.
You should go there right now and study about them, but we're going to talk to them, figure out who they are and where they're from and why they are. So I'm going to start right here. Go ahead.
I'm Jenny Carr. I'm from Pekin, Indiana.
Scott Sharman from Jeffersonville, Indiana, right here.
Right behind Scott's me, P-Mac, Perry McDaniel from Georgetown, Indiana.
I am Dave Charlton. I'm the only Kentuckian in the band from across the river in Shelbyville.
And I'm Craig Embry from Corydon, Indiana.
And we won't hold that Kentucky thing against
Please
you in
not.
Any way, shape, or form here. We're all okay. I'm in a band with three guys from Louisville, three guys from Indiana. We fight a lot.
He said he had to come all the way to Indiana to find a good band. Just saying.
Did he really say that?
Well, no, but it sounded good.
Yeah, it's good. Close
enough. All right, so Hush Harbor's been together for how long? When did it start?
Seven or eight years this month.
We'll go with eight.
I just decided that I was going to start a Christian band. I wasn't even a Christian yet. That's just kind of, I wasn't officially a Christian yet. I wanted to be.
Right.
I felt God calling me to start a band. And put an ad on Craigslist. I had a couple people reply. Knew Craig from Facebook. Ran into him in a music store.
Yeah,
he knew Dave. Met Perry. It just kind of all fell together real natural.
And then you got a singer. What's her name? What's her thing?
You know what?
How'd you meet her?
Sometimes you got to go through a whole lot of stuff to get to what you really want.
I got it.
And we got what we really want.
Absolutely.
Jenny kills
Absolutely.
It. We're so blessed.
Yeah. Jenny,
so blessed.
You've sang for a long time this town.
Yes.
I've heard your name a million times as I was through the years, right?
Yep.
And so the idea is I didn't know you, but I knew of you because I'd heard your name so many times from people. Hey, have you seen Jenny Carr sing? Have you seen that? I was like, no, I hadn't seen her sing. So with you guys, of course, I've seen her sing more than ever, right? Because every time I turn around, there's some kind of promo piece out on you guys, which is fantastic. But one, you're a Christian band.
Yeah.
And, you know, to be honest with you, you have stayed together. Where a lot of the bands, Christian bands in towns, I don't know, they seem to fall apart or whatever happens. And it's hard because, and you guys are different because you've created places to play and events to make happen, right? So you're a kind of a different thing where I think a lot of the Christian bands didn't go out and create events, didn't make things happen. And I know, Scott, you have a lot to do with this. You're a very creative weirdo.
That's exactly right.
And,
I love it.
Yeah, and you come up with a bunch of ideas and things to create events that allow you to do things, and you're always searching for that. And I think the band is, again, you probably play more events and actually have become the leaders, in a way, of Christian events in this town.
Well, it gives us opportunities to help other bands, too. That's
something
that we really like to do is be supportive of that and just foster that communal Christian band scene, and there actually is a Christian music scene here now, and that's awesome. Because when we started, I don't know that there was really anybody else, right, that we knew of.
It just really wasn't.
Well, I mean, we were very intentional from the start that we weren't a praise band. We all play in our churches, but we thought, and we tell churches that sometimes. Remember, we're not a praise band. We love that. We play in them. We are a Christian rock band.
Right.
Emphasis really on rock as well as Christian. And so we really, so many of the bands that are out there they're church bands. And we thought, we don't know that the Louisville metro area needs one more praise band.
There's some very talented praise bands.
Those are great. Yeah.
In that area.
We love
for
those.
Sure.
Yeah.
Right.
But that wasn't really our direction.
Right. Yeah. I definitely understand that because I've seen you guys play and it's like, you know, it's a different thing, you know, and I appreciate that. The thing is, you've done a great job. You also have a really nice sound system that you guys own. You have a really nice light system. You keep upping your game. It's something that I think is really important. Your merchandising is out of this world. Your video content, all of you guys being a team, it feels like you're a team. Like, you're always there to do something like, I mean, this is, we're shooting on a, what day is this? Thursday? Friday?
Thursday.
This is a Thursday. We're shooting right now, and this band shows up in the middle of the day. Everybody's got jobs and stuff, right? They've got lives. Yeah. But I have noticed this about your band, is that I watch a video, and you guys are all there. You're there promoing constantly about what you're involved in and what your next gig's going to be. And you're right. You pull a bunch of other artists, and you keep looking for other artists, because I get calls from you guys all the time going, hey, we're looking for more Christian artists to put on these shows. Do you know anybody?
Right.
And so I do think you're doing something great, not just being a band, but also bringing a culture of Christian bands in this town, right? Mm-hmm. I think that's a huge deal. So kudos.
We call it the Hush Harbor family. I mean, that's that Hush Harbor family. That's what we are, you know. And, you know, being a Christian band, you know, if you were to come to one of our rehearsals, here's what it looks like. So we all get there. We talk about what's going on in your life. What can we, who can we pray for? Can we pray for you? How's your son? How, son get moved into college? How's your wife? How's your wife? Or whatever it is, right? We pray, then we start working on music.
Right.
And then we pray at the end too. So it's for those church folks out there, this is my small group.
Exactly. Okay?
This is my small group.
Yeah. We can all agree with that.
Yeah. Yeah.
And if you don't mind, I'd love to speak a little bit about how you talked about, first of all, the community and creating events. I was in the mainstream country, you know, regional scene for almost 30 years. And we tried so hard multiple times. We had meetings, team meetings about this, about creating venues and creating our own events instead of constantly wondering, you know, oh, well, we got to get a gig in this place or we got to go to this place or whatever, and constantly trying to find venues to play. And creating a venue was something that we had tried to get together, and we never could get everybody on the same page. So going back to talking about our little family a little bit, when you've got Jesus at the center and you've got this common goal that you just want to go out and tell other people about Jesus, everybody gets on the same page and everything works so much better.
Fantastic.
Together. We have a full team working on that common goal. And when we talk about creating venues and creating events, we're all doing something with it. I mean, he's our mastermind that comes up with these crazy ideas.
Yeah.
He comes up with the technical portion. Yes, we can or can't. And then we all start plugging in.
Right.
And we all have our own individual parts that we do to make this thing work. And it's, for me, coming from where I came from and having so many people with, let's face it, there's a lot of egos. There's a lot of things that you struggle with out there in the mainstream area. But coming into a family where we've got that common goal, and we all work for that common goal, is just glorious for me.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Well, again, I've heard the word intentional too today. That's what you are. You're intentional. And so your past has been great. You've done so many cool things. You've played so many cool gigs. What's the future? What happens?
PMAC, what's our future, buddy?
Our future? We just keep getting more and more opportunities out there. And every time I feel like we've reached near the top, man, it just keeps going up and up, man. And it just keeps getting better every year.
I agree.
So, man, I don't know. It just keeps getting better.
There's new music coming out. So we would really, like, we've been very fortunate with some of our original stuff to get radio airplay on some stations in this area and beyond. And we'd love to get something new reaching out in a larger area in terms of airplay. If it does, it doesn't. It's okay. But we do part of what we do is original music. We do a lot of covers, but we're working on new music that we're hoping maybe before the end of this year to get new music released.
Yeah.
I'm really hoping so. Really excited about the stuff.
It will. Yeah.
Really, and that's something you got to be intentional about as well, because like you said earlier, we all have, you know, other careers and such, and you've got to set that time aside. And
yeah, I think you figure out what's really important. You make the plan to work towards that goal. And just like with your sound and your lighting and all the decisions you guys have made, and I've got to be honest with you, I would be lying if I hadn't counted you guys out maybe three times over the last 8 years. In other words, I would hear some news, and then I'd go, okay, that's over with. And then all of a sudden, it's recreated, right? And then it keeps going. And then I hear some news, and I think, that's over with. And then all of a sudden, it starts again, right? This time, is the strongest team yes. I have felt from this band.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I don't doubt you could pretty much do anything you wanted to do. Again, if you're focused in the right way.
Yes.
Who's at the center? So, anyway, do you have a website? Go again.
Yeah, hushharborband.com. You can find us on Facebook. You can find us on Instagram. Music's TikTok. On Spotify. We're on TikTok now, yeah.
Are you dancing on TikTok? Because if so, I'm watching.
Not Come me. On, Mark. Okay. Am I dancing? Come on. First video was me dancing.
Okay.
All of our music's on Spotify. You know, talk about streaming music. It's such a great thing. You know, I'm an old dude, and I think about, you know, you hand out cassette tapes, right?
Yeah.
You know,
mm-hmm.
And now we've had music streamed in like 39 countries or something like that.
Maybe over 40.
40.
Now,
and 40 that just blows that blows my mind. Talk about things we never set out for any of that.
Stand.
It just
oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, we had somebody buy something in Iraq.
Wow.
Which is
that's amazing.
Buying Christian music in Iraq's probably a little bit risky.
Yeah. Well, you know, it was funny because remember the rock when I was a kid, there was a band called Bride. Remember
oh, yes.
that?
Oh, yeah.
Rock
oh,
band.
Yes. Dale.
Jerry McGroom was in it. Yeah, a bunch
Lessons
of guys.
Over here
yeah. So, but you know, it's funny. They couldn't get a gig to save their life in this town. But you went to Brazil, and it would be
stadium.
It'd be a stadium,
yeah. Yeah.
right? And so it was
yes.
so strange how, you know, this you may not make it in your own backyard. You may make it in somebody else's backyard.
Right.
But the fact is, I don't know that that's the goal here. The goal is to do what you're doing, to stay together as a family, to keep playing music, and to worship God. And that's what you're doing well. And so, congratulations.
Thank you.
That's what I have to say. Look at them. Check them out. Figure them out. Go to a show. That's what we're asking here. Go check out Hush Harbor. Anything else to say before we go?
To support live music.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I couldn't agree more. Yeah. You know, I'll leave this one tip of a hat to you, Mark. So one of the things that we talked about when we very first started is kind of what we want to be. What, and we said,
I know where this is going.
We kind of want to be the Christian version of the Louisville Crashers.
Interesting.
Right?
Well, as my dad used to say to me when I would say, man, all I want to do is play the toy dagger, and he'd say, boy, you're shooting at the bottom of the barrel. Right? That my dad would actually say that, and I was like, no, man, it's a toy tiger. And now I got it after I've been there and did that.
Right on, man.
Yeah, well, you've done a great job. Matter of fact, in lots of ways, I've told you that, because you and I talk
sure,
quite a bit. I see everybody, but you and I talk a lot, and some of the things you guys have done as a band is overwhelming to me. Like it's like you're really pushing the ball in one direction, and it seems like everybody's behind it pushing.
That's a huge deal.
And in our situation, we've been together for 13 years, same way. I feel most of the time we're on the same side of the ball. Sometimes there's two guys and four guys and three guys and three guys that are fighting each other. But you guys really have. It seems, and I'm sure this is a view from the outside, that you've done a really good job staying together, doing what you're doing, swinging away for the fences, and being very humble about what this has become. You know, this is a great thing. And again, you've helped a lot of other bands in this town. You've created and made things happen that most people can't. And you've blessed a lot of people with it. So congrats to Hush Harbor.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Peace
out. God bless you. Thanks,